Hi everybody, in this video I will try to teach you factoring second degree trinomials with the leading coefficient, which is not equal to 1 if there is a leading coefficient. Again, to get this kind of expression, I need to have there product of two binomials. So to have there a coefficient, one of them should have, or both of them may have, some other numbers before them, like p and q, px and qx. Like the previous one, like the leading coefficient one, let's add some other numbers, m and n. When we multiply these two binomials, let's see what happens. Px times qx, p times q times x squared, plus px times n, p and x, plus m times qx, m times qx, and the last one m times n. Oh, again same. So if we combine the like terms, p and q times x squared, here we will have x, let's combine them. Pn will come from first, mq, or let's change the order, qm will come from the second one, and the constant number is m times n. So everybody, in this expression, except x, the other letters, they all shows different real numbers. So as we did in previous, if we copy this expression and move it down there, let's see, instead of a, I have a product of p and q. Instead of c, I have a product of m and n. So the important part is the mid part. So what happens in the mid part? I have p times n plus q times m. So in this order, if we do it, it will be in which way? P times n, like cross product, q times m. So what I want you to realize from here, at the end, p times n plus q times m must be equal to b. So we will find product of two numbers which makes c. Also we will find two numbers, product of them makes a. After that, when we multiply them crossly and add, we need to get the mid term b. So if we write it as a rule like this, look at that, ax squared plus bx plus c. So for c, I will find two numbers which their product makes c. For a, I will find two numbers which their product makes a. So I need to arrange these numbers to get the midterm. So what is the idea? When you multiply them crossly, p times n plus q times m, p times n plus q times m should be equal to b. When you find such dead numbers, you can factorize this expression as px plus m, look at that, px plus m, and qx plus n, qx plus n. Let's see it with different questions. Now I copied the formula here so you can see it always. So for 3 and for 4, I need to find two numbers. So for 4 or for 3, I have only one choice. It can be 1 times 3. I don't have any other choice for 3 or any other possibility. Also, it can be minus 1 and minus 3, but we can arrange it from the constant number if we need to arrange it. So in the example 1, the midterm is also positive, so I can keep these two as positive, because when I multiply and add, the result should be positive, so I can keep them as positive numbers. So to get 4, we have two choices. there can be 1 times 4 or 2 times 2. If I choose 2 times 2, let's try it. 2 times 3 or 1 times 2 will be 2. 3 times 2 will be 6. 6 plus 2 will be 8. So we cannot choose 2 and 2. Let's try 1 and 4. 1 times 4 is 4. 3 times 1 is 3. And 3 plus 4 is 7. It gives me the right number. 1 times 4 plus 3 times 1 equals 7. So these are the perfect numbers. So when you factorize it, you write them directly. 1x plus 1 times directly 3x plus 4. Look at here, px plus m qx plus n. So this cross product, we do it to check the mid number, to check the mid coefficient. So let's see the second example. In the second example, I only changed the midterm. I made it negative. So 4, 3 for the a, we have only one choice, 1 and 3. So I need to arrange this one. When I cross multiply and add them, the result should be negative. So if I make both numbers positive like previous, the result will be positive. But if I change both of them, 1 times minus 4 will be minus 4, 3 times minus 1 will be minus 3, it will be minus 7. So the result will be negative, but minus 7 doesn't satisfy 8. So what else can we try? We can change the place of these two numbers. Look at that. I can write minus 4 first, minus 1 second. 1 times minus 1 is minus 1. 3 times minus 4 is minus 12. Oh, minus 1, minus 12, minus 13. It didn't work also. So it shows me, or you can see that minus 1 and minus 4 doesn't work. So I need to choose the other ones, 2 and 2. I need to make both of them negative because I want the result to be negative. When I cross multiply and add, the result should be negative. Minus 2 and minus 2 makes 4. So even if I change the places, it doesn't matter because both of them same. Let's try. I hope that this works. 1 times minus 2 makes minus 2. 3 times minus 2 makes minus 6. So minus 2 and minus 6 gives me minus 8. So these are the perfect numbers which I can use to factorize this expression. So when we factorize, we write them directly. 1x minus 2 times 3x minus 2. Okay. Let's see the next example, example number 3. So in this example, I changed the constant number. I made it negative. When you make the constant number negative, remember that the numbers which you are gonna think of or which you are going to try to find, one of them should be positive, the other negative. So in this case, the midterm is positive. So I must keep the bigger product. Also remember that we will do cross multiply in here. The bigger product should be positive, so some of them must be negative. I am very lucky about that because for the number a, instead of a, we have 2. So we have only one choice, 1 and 2. So for 6, product of which numbers makes 6? Think about that. 1 times 6 or 2 times 3. To make it minus 6, I must make it minus 1 times plus 6. So look at that. 1 times 6 is 6. 2 times minus 1 is minus 2. 6 minus 2 is 4. Okay, it doesn't work for us. Let's change the places. Will it work for us? 6 and minus 1. 1 times minus 1, minus 1. 2 times 6, 12. 12 minus 1 is 11. 12 minus 1 is 11. Oh, it worked. Let's use it. 1 times minus 1 is minus 1. 2 times 6 is 12. It is positive 12, so I can use plus. 12 minus 1 gives me 13. Oh, pardon, 12 minus 1 gives me 11. So these are the numbers which I can use. So remember that when I write the factorization form, factorized, so I need to write them directly. 1x plus 6, then 2x minus 1. We also can cancel this 1x. I didn't do it in previous ones. Let's do it for this one, only for this one. I think that you can guess it, you can find it. X plus 6 times 2x minus 1. Minus 1. And I think we can go to the next page, question number 4. In this question, the constant number is again negative. So for this negative, I need to use different signed numbers. I'm really, really lucky because I chose the perfect ones. For the number A, we have number 2 here. Instead of A, we have the number 2 here. And we have only one choice about this. We have only one choice about this. One time, so we don't have any other choice. Yes. Now, for 10, the possibilities are 1 times 10 and 2 times 5. So I need to arrange them. This, right? 1 times 10. I need to arrange them as one of them will be negative. So the mid one is negative. I will make cross product and add. So I need to make the bigger product negative. So 10 is bigger one. So let's make this one negative. 1 times minus 10 gives me minus 10. Let's try to cross product. 1 times minus 10 is minus 10. 2 times 1 is 2 plus 2. Minus 10 plus 2 makes minus 8. So it gave me the result directly. So these are the perfect numbers. Let's say you chose 2 and 5. In this case, you must keep the bigger one negative. So 1 times 5, 2 times 2. So 1 times 5 is bigger. If you keep this one negative, 1 times minus 5 will be minus 5. 2 times 2 will be plus 4. It will give you minus 1. So you cannot use these numbers. Let's say you chose firstly those two numbers. So we have found that 1 and 2 minus 10 are the perfect numbers. If you chose these two numbers, that's the way which you can try. At the end, I hope that you can find perfect numbers which satisfies the rule which we made. So when we write the factorization, we must write them directly in direct order. 1x plus 1, 1x plus 1 in this row, 2x minus 10, 2x minus 10. If I continue, if I cancel this 1x, I can write there directly x plus 1 times 2x minus 10. Some of you may realize that we can also continue to factorize with the second factor. Look at that, we have there 2x minus 10. We can take the factor 2 out of parentheses. X plus 1 times, if 2 comes out of parentheses, 2 times what gives me 2x? 2 times x. 2 times what gives me minus 10? 2 times minus 5. So if we write them in the perfect order as we wish, if we move 2 to the first place, 2 times x plus 1 times x minus 5 will be the final result. So there is only one case more. If the first term is negative, so in this kind of cases, as I have done in the previous one, and the leading term is positive one, if you see here a negative one, a negative number, take negative one parentheses. Let's take negative 1 out of parentheses. Oops. Clean. If we take negative 1 out of parentheses, So I need to find negative 1 times what gives me 5x squared plus 5x squared. Negative 1 times what gives me plus 3x. Negative 1 times negative 3x. Negative 1 times what gives me plus 2. Negative 1 times negative 2. Now we can factorize this expression. So let's think about the possibilities, which are the numbers. For 5, I have only two choices, 1 and 5. For minus 2, oh, I must keep them different. The signs must be different. I must use 1 and 2 or 2 and 1. Also, one of them must be minus. So the midterm is negative, so I must keep the bigger product negative. 1 times 2 will give me, oh, let's write this one better. It looks... doesn't look well. 1 times 2 will give me 2. 5 times 1 will give me 5. So the bigger one should be negative. So minus 1 times minus 2 gives me minus 1 times 2 gives me minus 2. 1 times 5 is 5. Let's multiply them crossly. 1 times 2 is 2. 5 times minus 1 is minus 5. 2 minus 5 gives me minus 3, which is the perfect number. So let's factorize this. In the beginning, I need to write minus 1 again. So after that, 1x minus 1, we can write it as x minus 1. Then second row, 5x minus 2. In this case, I cannot continue to factorize. Also, you can multiply one of them by minus 1 and you can make it simpler, but there is no need to do that. We can keep minus 1 over there. It is a factorization of this expression. Thank you for listening. I hope that you can learn with this video.